Hello, Leute. Hi, boys and girls. That was a little bit German, sorry. Hi, guys. Volume 2, Chapter 2, Welcome to Beacon. So, who do we have to welcome? Because the main protagonists are already welcomed, I guess. Hey, good witch.
Ironwood certainly loves bringing his work wherever he travels.
Well, and Ospen?
Running an academy in a military Ooh. Makes him a busy man. But yes, those are a bit of an eyesore.
That sounded a little bit like text-to-speech. Brah, 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 brah. Ironwood? Is that Ironwood?
It has certainly been too long since we last met.
Oh, James. I'll be outside.
Oh.
Well, so, she hasn't changed
for a second I thought they had a thing together, but what in the they world clearly has didn't.
Brought you all the way down from Atlas? Headmasters don't typically travel with their students for the Vital Festival.
Ah, headmaster.
Well, you know how much I
What's
love
the Vital Festival.
Besides, with you hosting, I thought this might be a good opportunity for us to catch up.
I can certainly appreciate quality time between friends.
You
However,
do? You care?
A small fleet outside my window has me somewhat concerned.
Huh.
You and I both know why I brought those men.
And why? I don't know.
We are in a time of peace. Shows of power like this are just going to give off the wrong impression.
But if what Crow said is true, then...
If what Crow said is true, then we will handle it tactfully.
Do you honestly believe your children can win a war?
Well, I don't know about that. They're not that experienced yet, I'd say.
I hope they never have to.
Yeah. Good answer. Hello, you guys.
All right.
Oh, they're playing cool. Thank God. Right. Oh, Blake lost.
Ying Xiaolong, prepare your kingdom for battle.
Bring it on.
I deploy the Elysian Air Fleet.
Looks like I get to fly right over your Ursi and attack your wolf directly.
Oh my God, is it a little bit like Risk? A bit?
My repair time only lasts one turn.
Pretty sneaky, sis. But you just activated my trap card.
Uh-oh.
Giant Nevermore! If I roll a 7 or higher, Fatal Feathers will slice your fleet in two.
But if you roll a 6
I
or
love
lower,
games
Nevermore
too.
Will turn on your own forces.
Oh, Nora. Never change. You're so cute. He's reading comics. Nora is actually studying, I guess. Yeah, study. Hey, why? Oh, that was cheeky.
See, now you could take Ruby's discard air fleet
and put it in your hand.
Okay.
Yeah.
And since Vacuo warriors have an endurance boost against natural hazards,
okay, I don't like games that are that complex.
My ground forces and simultaneously infiltrate my kingdom. Just know that I will not forget this declaration of war.
And that means
she should be the leader because she's definitely the best strategist.
Huh? Yes. Fear the almighty power of my forces. Cower as they pillage your homes and weep as they take your children from your very arms.
Trap card. Huh?
What?
Your armies have been destroyed.
What?
I hate this game of emotions we play. These strong wise will make it through this together.
Yeah, I got a. I shipped you. Me. Oh my God.
All right, Blake.
Don't judge me. Huh? Oh my God. Oh, is that cute?
Sorry, what am I doing?
You're playing as Vale, trying to conquer the kingdoms of Remnant.
I thought she was losing, but she doesn't even care.
Can I play?
Sorry, Jean, we've already got four people. You attacked your own naval fleet 2 turns ago.
Bring it on, Ice Queen.
Ooh, that's lame.
That I've been told I'm a natural-born leader.
By who? Your mother?
And Pyrrha.
Hello again.
Come on, let me play your hand for a turn.
I'm not trusting you with the good
I ship you again. Like hell.
I mean, you told us all that Blake is secretly a
fun-loving person whom we all admire and respect.
Uh-oh. Okay, your secret is not safe.
Ladies, enjoy your battle.
Sup, losers?
Hi.
Hey,
son. Ruby? Son. Yang, son is Blake? His name.
I don't believe I've caught your name, Snow Angel.
I'm Weiss.
Are you kidding me?
Pleasure to meet you.
He's coming through with Snow Angel. Oh my God.
I'll see you guys later.
Still interested in her, huh? Oh my God, look at this. Yeah, this absence is crazy. Then again, look at the boobs of the girls.
The White Fang and I are going in.
This has certainly been an eventful evening.
Hmm.
I'm sure that after a night of thwarting attempted robbery, you probably just want to go home and take a nap. But most applicants spend years of preparation training at one of the many combat schools around the world.
Mm-hmm.
You are one of the few who did not. And you passed the exam with flying colors.
Whoa.
I was raised outside the kingdoms. Mm. If you can't fight, you can't survive.
Well, you have most certainly survived, Blake. And I am proud to run a school that accepts individuals from all walks of life. Rich, poor, human.
He knows.
Faunus. Why do you wear that bow, Blake?
He knows.
Why hide who you are?
You may be willing to accept the Faunus, Professor Ozpin, but your species is not. Until then, I'd rather avoid any unnecessary attention. I want people to see me for who I am, not what I am.
No, okay.
And yeah, what are you?
I don't understand what you're asking.
Mm-hmm. How did you know the White Fang would be at the shipyard tonight? I may be your headmaster, but I am also a huntsman.
No.
And it is my sworn duty to protect this world from the forces that conspire against it.
Mm-hmm.
Blake.
Understandably so.
Are you sure there is nothing else you would like to tell me?
I'm sure.
Oh, Blake.
Very well.
He knows there's more to talk about. Okay, he's disappointed.
If you ever need to talk to me, please don't hesitate to ask.
I would trust him.
You should have never let him play. You're just mad because the new guy beat you.
Oh,
see,
he
if
did?
If you were just attacked when I told you, none of this would have happened.
He's a bigger nerd than her. Huh?
Lately, you've been quiet, antisocial, and moody.
Have you met Blake?
Which I get is kind of your thing, but you've been doing it more than usual. That you would let us know if something was wrong.
Wow.
So, Blake Belladonna, what is wrong?
Okay. Not very graceful, but cute as hell.
Something big is happening and no one is doing anything about it.
Yeah.
Ozpin told us not to worry.
We don't know what.
Between the police and the huntsman, I'm sure they could handle it.
Well, I'm not. They don't know the White Fang like I do.
Then you should maybe talk to him?
We're not ready. And we may never be ready. Our enemies aren't just going to sit around and wait for graduation.
Yeah, good point too.
They're out there somewhere planning their next move. And none of us know what it is, but it's coming. Whether we're
ready
or not.
Or you could try to do something.
Okay. All in favor of becoming the youngest huntress to single-handedly bring down a corrupt organization conspiring against the Kingdom of Hale, say aye. Yes!
I love it when you're feisty.
Well, I suppose it could
yeah,
be
I love it too.
None of you said aye.
All right, then.
Mm.
We're in this together. Let's hatch
yes.
a plan. Yeah! I left my board game in the library.
We're doomed.
I'll be right back!
What?
Okay?
I enjoy
I'm
the
fine.
Expression so much.
Just watch where you're going.
Oh, fuck.
Right, sorry.
The bad guys.
I'm Ruby. Are you new?
Visiting from Haven, actually.
No, how to?
Ooh, you're here for the festival. Oh, but exchange students have
not
their own
only
dormitory.
That.
I guess we just got turned around.
Don't worry, happens all the time. Your building is just east of here.
Thanks. Maybe we'll see you around.
Maybe we'll fight someday.
And welcome to Beacon.
Welcome to Beacon, I guess. Oh, nice fan art. Oh, this song is cool. Yeah, let's take this picture. Isn't that cute? So, what I appreciate of this season already is that they took much more thought into how to place the expressions. Like, there are more smiles here. In the last season, there often were situations where they were talking about emotional stuff, and the mouth just moved this and that, and was like the stiff puppet in a way. Only the very good actors, the voice actors here, they hit the spots and made it believable. Sometimes they look too much like puppets, but now they begin to look more like actually the thing, like the feelings. Of course, there were also many moments in the first season where they hit those marks, but here it's more the case inside the episodes than usual than in volume one. Yeah, this was a very nice episode. The very first episode was not that much my thing. It was okay. This episode was much better. We had nice moments between Ozpin and Blake, and we had fun moments with the whole crew. And also Sam was there, and now I know that the other guy is called Neptune. Fun moments, and not so much main story. More like, okay, this is happening here, and now you see that the bad guys are coming into the school for some reason. I wonder if they are together associated with the Ironwood guy. Don't tell me, yeah, I don't want to know yet, but it could be that they are kind of making business together, you know. Maybe they even force him to make business or something like that. Anyway, that's it. See you in the next one, and see you on the other side. Bye.